Hello again and welcome back to our course on Project 2016 Advanced. In this section we're going to set up a master project for the charity event, and we're going to start with our original project, the one that's called Charity Event All, and the Sports Day project that we've already created. Remember that those two projects are now both sharing a resource pool called Charity Event Resources. And really, when it comes to splitting a large project or program into a number of constituent projects or subprojects, the key area where there is usually the most effort is in restoring any links that existed in the original program or project. And this goes right back to a point that I made a couple of times already on the course. It's a good idea to decide whether you're going to split a program or project into a number of separate files as early on in the process as you can, or you do finish up with quite a bit of work to do. Now, what I'm going to do here is to demonstrate how to deal with that one project. And then what I'm going to do is to set you exercise one on the course where you're going to split off the other projects that make up all of the charity event. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is to open Charity Event All. You need to look carefully at what happens when I do this. Now, it says this file shares resources from a resource pool. What do you want to do? You can open the resource pool to see the assignments across all sharer files, or do not open other files. Now, if I open this project on its own, although I'll be able to see the list of resources that it uses, I won't be looking at the resource pool and all of the sharer projects, so I won't get an accurate picture of resource usage. So what I'm going to do here is to select the first option. Now, it's very interesting if you go to the View tab here and look at Switch Windows, because what you'll see is that we have the Charity Event All project open normally. We have the resource pool open read-only. We don't have the Sports Day project open. Now, let me just move this across here. Now, although I don't have the Sports Day project open, the resource pool is aware of the resource assignments in that project, and I can see them here on the resource sheet in Resource Usage View. So that's a very important point. I can see how the resources are being used, even though I don't have all of the projects open. I do, however, need to have the resource pool open. So, having pointed that out, let me now go back to the Gantt chart for the All project. Note that I have the planning summary task expanded here. The gala dinner and fashion show and buffet lunch summary tasks are both collapsed, and the sports day and barbecue summary task is expanded as well. Now, as you can see from this, there are links, dependencies between the sports day and barbecue summary task tasks and the planning summary task tasks. And what I need to do is to replace the sports day summary task with my separate project and then re-establish these links. Now, I need to explain a couple of things as we go through this, but the first thing I need to do is to insert the sports day project into the All project. I select an empty row and I go to the Project tab, and on the left I have an Insert group with the option Subproject. Insert subproject. Insert a related project as a subproject. Click on that, browse to the course files folder and select Sports Day. Click on Insert. Now, you can immediately see that this is an inserted subproject because you see that icon there in the I column. But note that, as usual, when you insert something into a table, it assumes the indentation of the task above. So this particular project, although we've inserted it as a separate project, is currently within the Sports Day and Barbecue Summary Task 46. So one of the first things I need to go, if I go to the Task tab, is to outdent it so that it isn't part of that summary task. Now let me expand the subproject and return to a point that I made earlier on in the course. When I selected the tasks to make this, I selected the summary task, sports day and barbecue, and that has been included within the subproject. It may well be that when you do that, you want to do that. It may well be that you don't actually select the summary task when you create a subproject in the way that I did earlier. Now, if I hadn't selected the summary task when I did that copy, then I would have only had the tasks here 2 to 11 in the subproject. And in fact, I could lose the sports day and barbecue summary task within the subproject now if I wanted to, having selected 2 to 11. If I outdent them all and then get rid of that one, I've still got everything I need within my subproject. I've got everything within it that I need, but of course the scheduling is very wrong. And the reason it's very wrong is that I don't have the correct dependencies. Within the subproject, I have internal dependencies, but I don't have the dependencies relating to the planning summary task in the all project. The other thing to notice here is that if you look at the all project, note the ID numbers. They go down right down to 56. And in fact, task 58 is the inserted subproject. But within the inserted subproject, it has its own ID numbering. So you have tasks 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So when you look at the dependencies within the subproject, for instance, the dependency here, task 2, obtain insurance. Its predecessor is task 1, perform risk assessment. Whereas in the all project, task 48, obtain insurance, its predecessor is 47, perform risk assessment. So although we need to establish all of the correct dependencies, bear in mind that the numbering system within the subproject is different. Having said that, all of those internal dependencies are there, so that's fine. So it's only the dependencies to the all project that I need to establish. Now the great thing about leaving the original sports day and barbecue summary task in there for the moment is that I can use the dependencies there in order to build the dependencies to the subproject. So for instance, let's start at the beginning. Task 47, perform risk assessment, has a predecessor of task 10. If I go up to task 10, it's actually book venue. So I've selected book venue. Now I'm going to go down to my subproject and I'm going to select perform risk assessment there. And I'm going to create that equivalent link. Click on the link, and now I can see some of the tasks in my subproject are correctly scheduled. But interestingly, if I look at the predecessor is expressed in a different way to the other predecessors that we have, because it doesn't, as with here, task 47 has a predecessor of 10. Because the predecessor for task 1 in the subproject is in a different project, the predecessor is now expressed in a more complex way. So where we're dealing with dependencies between projects, we have the project path, the project file name, and the task ID within the project as part of the dependency. Now, I can follow exactly the same principle now. For example, if I go to the next task down, prepare draft sports day program of events, that relates to task 4, which is meeting 1. Select meeting 1, come down here, select the equivalent task within the subproject, click on the link. That task is also now scheduled correctly. Now there are a couple more of those. I'll do those and join me again. So basically now I have specified, hopefully correctly, all of the predecessors for the tasks within the subproject. But as you'll see from the Gantt chart, the bars and lines, there's also some dependencies in the other direction. So for instance, if we look at the final task in the sports day summary task up here, 61, it has at least one successor. So I also need to make sure that any successors are set up correctly as well. So for example, we have sports day and barbecue, 61, has as a successor task 15, which is vacate venue. I need to set up that as a successor to task 14 in the subproject. Now, sports day and barbecue, select it first to make sure that it is the predecessor. Then go to task 15, select that second, vacate venue. Click on the link. Just go back and check that the successor is set up correctly. And then what I need to do is to go through and set up any other successors that are needed for the tasks in the subproject. So again, join me again when I've done that. So having made sure that I've set up all of my predecessors and successors correctly, the next thing that I'm going to do is to delete the sports day and barbecue summary task, as it is now completely replaced by the subproject. So I'm going to select the summary task, hit delete. Sports day and barbecue is a summary task. Deleting it will delete all its subtasks as well. That's okay. And it is now deleted. And it has in effect been replaced by the subproject. Now, one of the things that you've probably noticed by now, particularly if you look at the IDs within the sports day subproject, is that the numbering has got gaps. It goes 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You may also have noticed, as we've been going through doing the work in this section, that the numbering of tasks in the all project has changed as well. There are some numbers missing. All of the tasks are still there, but the numbering goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, and there are various gaps. Now, don't worry about the gaps, because I'm going to talk about those a little bit later on in the course. For the moment, I've replaced the summary task by the subproject, and the scheduling of the sports day is correct and as it was. However, the other thing you may have spotted there is that even though we have dependencies between the subproject and the rest of the project, you can't see any lines representing those dependencies. And in fact, there should be lines there. Now, at the time of recording the course, this is a known issue with Project 2016. And although it was reported some time ago, we don't have any date for a fix to this particular issue. Now, it doesn't stop the dependencies actually being effective, and of course you can still see the dependencies by looking at predecessors and successors in various places. You just can't see the lines that we normally see representing dependencies. Now, hopefully Microsoft will come out with a fix for that very soon. In the meantime, you can always check that the dependencies are there, but you won't be able to see those clear lines that we normally see when dependencies exist. So the last thing I'm going to do in this section is to close down Microsoft Project. So I'm going to click on Close. Do you want to save your changes to All? Yes, I do. Do you want to save your changes to Sports Day? Yes, I do. Do I want to update the resource pool to reflect the changes for all the open sharer projects? Now, it's important that you read this particular message carefully, because it explains what to do in situations where you only want to save some of the changes in the sharer projects. But for the moment, we're going to save everything, so I'm going to click on OK. And that is finished. That's the end of this section. I'll see you in the next one.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right and check out our other Office 2016 tutorials below. I'll see you next week with new tutorials.